some of the best practices you should have is make sure you have a very good, you know, data model, which is very, very important part of your system. Because if the data model is wrong, then the overall, you know, consumption at the client layer will have problems. Second thing is your best practice. You should always have a data flow diagram with you. How the overall data is flowing to a data warehouse, you should have definitely a data flow diagram so that you can anytime refer if any issues or doubts will come. Third part is you should have integration layer, which is independent of the tools and technology. You should build one kind of integration. This is how I am going to integrate various source systems to the target systems. Third part is your data and technology standardization, particularly which kind of model you are trying to build. Let's say it is this kind of star schema, or you are trying to build a snowflake schema, or you are trying to aggregate and denormalize the data. So this is very, very important. You should have this best practices. That will depend, that will decide your end user's performance in terms of consumption. Then you should have a various very good development practices like agile methodology, and should have very good integration with your DevOps, so that whatever you are developing your applications, you can quickly check in and check out, as well as parallel development can be done. As I said, you know, earlier also, the parallel development, which is kind of concept of microservices architecture. And if you have some kind of automation in the sense when I'm telling lot of development of tables and procedures, lot of a source target mapping is required. If you have kind of some kind of automation tool like Fire Escape and all, so that will help accelerate this kind of object creation and object mapping. And finally, you make sure that all the, you know, new joiners are properly trained to the new system, because Snowflake or a large scale data warehouse require kind of some kind of, you know, discipline and some kind of learning. So these few things, 7 or 8 things, if you take care, your process of development will smoothen, and you should have good, you know, documentation, you know, which even that automation tool can take care of a lot of automation and integration also. So overall, 7 to 8 steps are required so that your data warehouse development can be rapid and smooth.